about Steller Sea Lions first arose in 1990. Steller Sea Lions are currently viewed by federal managers as two distinct groups, those that are born west of longitude 144 in Alaska and Russia, and those that are born east of that line, exclusively in the United States. The population of eastern region sea lions has been growing for the past 20 years, and they may soon be removed from the endangered species list. However, sea lions in some sub-areas of the western region continue to decline, but there is no clear scientific answers to why. Sea lions are typically monitored from airplanes and large boats, but getting good data is difficult because poor weather often prevents scientists from reaching many of these areas. Because population monitoring cannot be done on a routine basis, it can result in large seasonal and spatial gaps in the data. The use of traditional manned aircraft surveys give scientists a snapshot of the Steller Sea Lion population, but a thorough understanding of changes in the local environment and the impact of those changes cannot be inferred from those surveys. This leaves gaps in our understanding of sea lion population increases and declines, particularly in the remote western Aleutians where there are the most concerns. In response to continuing concerns about small subregions of the western population of Steller Sea Lions, the National Marine Fisheries Service has shut down productive fishing grounds that cover an area half the size of Texas and imposed additional restrictions on an area twice that size. This controversial closure has cost Alaska's coastal communities and the seafood industry more than $60 million and 750 jobs per year in an area where there are no other economic opportunities. Working with the University of Alaska and federal scientists, the seafood industry has taken the lead to develop new unmanned aircraft to fill the information gaps. A group of engineers, scientists, and other researchers travel the Aleutian chain testing new unmanned aircraft for sea lion survey work. Two unmanned aircraft were used, a fixed-wing Puma that can travel at 20 to 40 knots, and an Arion Scout quadcopter. The project was designed to determine the feasibility of using unmanned aircraft to conduct cost-effective aerial surveys. Unmanned aircraft can fly in marginal weather conditions, and they don't need runways or elaborate support systems, which typically limit the manned aircraft surveys. So, how did it go? Once the team got to a sea lion's sight, if they decided to fly from the boat, they were typically in the air in 20 minutes. If they decided to fly from the beach, it might take them another 20 minutes to launch the small inflatable and set up to operate from shore. That's pretty efficient. The team quickly discovered that unmanned aircraft are particularly useful for rugged, complicated sea lion sites that are difficult to look at from the water or inaccessible from land. They could also look beyond the specific spot where sea lions had been previously seen to make sure that they were conducting a complete count, which is very important in this situation. Many missions were completed in 30 minutes or less. With an unmanned aircraft, you get up into the air, you get a lot of data quickly, and you're done. A scientist doesn't need to sit on the beach or a moving boat there for several hours. This really minimizes any human impact on the sea lions. The cost of the unmanned aircraft is falling rapidly. The real challenge is developing the software and camera packages for specific projects like this. These unmanned aircraft have been customized to shoot high-resolution and infrared video. Aerial infrared video is a breakthrough tool for sea lion survey work because it differentiates between the cold Aleutian Islands background and the much warmer Steller Sea Lions. Since the completion of the research trip, the resulting data has been used to create 3D models of some of the rookeries. The learning curve with this new technology is, for the moment, exponential in nature. This research trip was designed to test the utility of unmanned aircraft for research in the Aleutian Islands, and there were some limits in their current configurations. With the Puma, once the winds get above 25 knots, it is difficult to launch the craft. The crew has to be able to throw the unmanned aircraft into the wind. The Puma simply could not be launched in high winds. With a better camera and more wind tolerance, scientists have to go on shore less often. They can fly the area, get the data, and they don't even need to get off the boat to conduct the survey.